So, Kasi, today I brought this really nice clip from Steve Jobs, actually. And Steve Jobs was known for being a great communicator. And in this clip, I think it is from 2007, he's actually introducing the iPhone for the very first time.
Well, what we're going to do is get rid of all these buttons and just make a giant screen. A giant screen. Now, how are we going to communicate this? We don't want to carry around a mouse, right? So what are we going to do? Oh, a stylus, right? We're going to use a stylus. No. No. Who wants a stylus? You have to get them and put them away and you lose them. Yuck. Nobody wants a stylus. So let's not use a stylus. We're going to use the best pointing device in the world. We're going to use a pointing device that we're all born with. We're born with 10 of them. We're going to use our fingers. We're going to touch this with our fingers. And we have invented a new technology called multi-touch, which is phenomenal. It works like magic.
That was awesome.
All right, really cool, yeah.
I love the way that he presented that. Like, it doesn't only make me, I mean, this is old, yeah. So obviously I know what's coming. I don't know, it's just still so engaging. I'm still, I want to watch more. You know, that's how I feel watching that segment, but it's an amazing delivery.
First of all, the very first phrase there, what we're going to do is get rid of all these buttons.
Well, what we're going to do is get rid of all these buttons.
First of all, it's important to point out how he pronounces the word buttons. You see, he says button.
Buttons.
Not button, all right? So there is a bit of a glottal sound there. Button, button, all right? That's how he says it, button. And the sentence goes, what we're. So the T for what here, he doesn't pronounce, so he drops that. So he says what. What, like a stop consonant, what we're going to do becomes what we're gonna do. And then he goes, get rid, the T for get disappears. It's kind of a stop T again. Get rid of all. So the D for rid connects with the vowel O for the preposition of, and it has that flap sound, da 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 da. So we go rid of. And then the F is pronounced as a V, which then joins with the O, the vowel A there. So of all. So we say, get rid of all. What we're gonna do is get rid of all these buttons.
Well, what we're gonna do is get rid of all these buttons.
I can't say, he talks about a stylus. Mm-hmm. Like, who wants a stylus? Nobody wants a stylus. What is that, a stylus?
The stylus is the pen that is used on, well, it's no longer used as often as it was, but it's the pen that was used to sort of write or type out messages on the BlackBerry, basically, was what he was using in the clip. So it's the pen that's used to do that.
And we have some more connected speech here to break down. Mm-hmm. Could you break down the next part here about Sure. Get them?
Yeah, so we're going to see something similar quite later on when he mentions 10 of them as well. It's all basically using the same type of connected speech. Every time he says them in this clip, you'll notice that the TH sound is basically silent. He reduces it to
You have to get them and put them away and you lose them.
So we will see that with get them and put them, the T at the end of get and the T at the end of put is pronounced as a flap T sound. So it sounds like a duh sound. Get them, put them away. And then when he says lose them, you know, that one sort of, the lose stays the same, but it sort of connects, lose them. It sounds like one word, right?
And what I found interesting was the way he goes, yuck. This is an expression you can use in English to express disgust.
Yuck.
But you see, he's selling the iPhone. He's selling the idea of the iPhone. And the way he uses his voice here, he sounds very enthusiastic. He goes, who wants a stylus? It's like, it's absurd. You see the voice. Eh? Who wants a stylus? You have to get them, put them away, and you lose them. You see?
Yeah.
Yuck. Right?
Yeah.
So you see how he uses the voice. Yeah. It modulates a lot. It rises and falls. This is a good example, actually, of a person who is using their voice well in a public speaking context. By the way, if you want to take your English to the next level, make sure you download the Real Life English app. With the app, you can listen to our podcasts and access a full interactive transcript from the latest published podcast. Also, you can have access to some flashcards to improve vocabulary and connect with any learner around the world at the touch of a button to practice your speaking skills with. To download the app is really simple. All you need to do is click on the link in the description of this video or go to Google Play Store or Apple App Store, search for Real Life English and download the app from there. Now, still breaking down connected speech here, we have the best pointing device.
The best pointing device in the world.
So the T for best here disappears. We say the best pointing, but he does something else there. The word pointing has this combination of N and T. Usually when you have that combination of N and T, especially in American English, the T tends to be dropped. So we don't pronounce, we only pronounce the N. So instead of saying pointing, we hear pointing, pointing with the N there. So the best pointing device, he says. The same thing happens a little bit later in the clip with the word invented.
And we have invented.
You see again, invented, we have that N and T combination. The T goes away, so I pronounce only the N. Invented, invented.
And we have invented.
I think the purpose here is to get people excited. So I think when you're communicating and you're thinking about the purpose of why you're saying what you're saying, you want to make people feel there's an emotion you want them to feel, or there's an action you expect them, a reaction you might want from them. So you need to bring that out. You know, imagine you're trying to sell something to someone and you're like, yeah, it's magic. Yeah, put him away. I mean, if you're... You don't seem excited about it, so why would they get excited about it? And he sort of brings that out. He seems like he's convinced that this is going to change the world. This is amazing. No one's ever seen anything like it. And I get that from him. That's the energy he brings across. And, you know, look at his hands when he talks about, like, he's using his hands, he's using his full body to sell you this idea.
Mm-hmm. That is a great point. Yeah, because we are talking all about the voice today, but communication, effective communication goes beyond the voice. It's also about the body language. Awesome.
Every type of interaction that we have, whether we are, you know, having conversations with our team members, like we are, like we have meetings, or we are speaking to each other right now, this is technically public speaking, and it can happen on many different levels. Like, it could be a team meeting where it's five people. It could be, you know, the entire company meeting where you're actually presenting something to everyone in the company. Or it could just be a conversation with friends, where you're talking to a group of friends. It's more than just like presentations and, yeah, large groups of people in a theater. So, on a stage, for example, this is important to remember.
I want to mention something curious I've learned about Warren Buffett, actually. For those of you who don't know, Warren Buffett is perhaps one of the most famous and influential American investors of all time. He has made billions investing in the stock market. And in one of his interviews, he attributes his success to his ability of public speaking.
One of the things you would want to be sure to do is, whether you like it or not, get very comfortable, it may take a while, with public speaking, for example.
So he said that when he was younger, in his younger years, he actually took this public speaking course, and that really helped him in his career. I thought it was interesting that he didn't mention his knowledge of the stocks or his knowledge of economy or the market. He mentioned his ability of being a public speaker. And it's curious because in his office, he doesn't have his college diploma hanging on the wall. He doesn't have that. He has the certificate of the public speaking course he took in his younger years. So to illustrate how important learning this skill of public speaking was for him and his career.
It gets me thinking about the fact that, like, in order to be successful, you need to be able to communicate. You can have a wealth of knowledge inside of your head, but you need to be able to communicate that to other people. And you need to be able to convince them that what you are saying is important and worth their time as well. So it's very interesting.
Hey, so this is the end of this lesson, but if you enjoyed learning English vocabulary and pronunciation with it, you should know that this clip was just a part of an episode of the Real Life English podcast. And we release a new episode every week. So come check it out right now by clicking here on this video.